Welcome to the DBMS class. Let us begin our class by discussing about the relationships and the relationship set in the ER diagrams. We will be taking up relations and relationship sets in ER diagrams. As far as earlier discussion is concerned, we talked about an entity set constituting of attributes, thereby a relationship with another entity set. Now, the primary key item in the entity set is going to be represented with an underline. So, in an employee set, employee number is going to be the primary key. Similarly, there is another entity set. In this another entity set, we are going to assume the department ID as an underline, as primary. So, employee has this employee number, employee name, and this salary. These are the three key items. Worksheet is going to be a relation, and it is going to have its own attribute. That is what we are going to call it as a SINS, and it is going to have another entity set where it does has department ID as a primary key and other values as department number. So, this is how we are going to build up a relationship between two entity sets. Next word, relationship set. Next, we have to migrate to the word called as a relationship set. Putting only works in here is going to be a relationship. Is going to be only a relationship. But for this, we are going to include an attribute. We are going to put some attribute here that it is going to become a relationship set. So this SINS, it can be used towards an employee, nor it can be used towards a department. It can be used to an employee, nor it can be used to a department. Now, here is a relationship set which we are going to represent E1 to EN as different entities, and E1 is going to belong to an entity set. So, E1 to E1, we are going to call it as an entity here, and uppercase we are going to call it as entity set. Okay, so we are going to choose different entities to make this entity set. So this is all regarding relationships. So what we have talked up to here is we are going to build an association. We are going to build up an association. How are we building an association? We are taking table 1 and we are taking table 2. Between table 1 and table 2, we are going to make a relation. We are going to link table 1 with table 2. How I am going to link? I am going to link it with a relation, or I am going to link it with a relation set. What is the difference? If I am taking only one key, then it is going to be called as relationship. If I am going to take working and I am going to put an attribute here, then it is going to be called as relationship set. Got it? So this is the primary key. Next one. We talked about association, then we talked about relationship set. After this, if I am going to call it as an employee, assume our college is there. College has 200 or 300 employees. So 200 employees are there, 200 employee IDs are there, 200 employee names are there, 200 people are going to get their salary. So all those we are going to call them as an instances. So this is employee 1, this is employee 2, employee 3 and employee 4. Assume the employee he is going to work. Assume the employee he is going to work in CSE department. Then his ID is going to start with 5. Assume the employee is going to work in ECE department. Then his ID is going to start with 4. Similarly, 5. Again, he is a CSE guy. Next, it is 2. Then we are going to assume he is going to be a triple A. Right? So, the first set, the first entity set, we are going to have some different types of instances. 501, 403, 560 and 223. This is going to be a total participation. That is, all the employees are in a set. All the employees are going to be represented into the set. Next one. There is another data, another table, and this table is going to have department IDs. Yeah, 5, it is going to indicate CSE department. 4, it is going to indicate ECE department. 2, it is going to indicate AAA department. Now, what is here a relationship was, this employee from this time, he is going to work in this department. So that is what we have to make a derivation. How long an employee is working in ECE, how long an employee working in CSE, you want to make his identity. That means a person is working in CSE department from this period to this period. After few months, he was transferred from this department to another department. You want to make a relationship. So for that, you are going to make an association between everyone and table. So now, we are going to work on a relationship set called as working. We are going to work with a working relation. Now, relation we are going to call, right? Relation. When we are going to call it as relations, there are four types of relations. There are four types of relations. One to one relation, one to many relation, many to one relation, and many to many relations. One to one relation, one to many relation, many to one relation, many to many relations. Now, working relation is built on, working relation is built on many to many relations. It is going to build on many to many relations. So, how is it formed? How is it formed? So now, I can say, guy 501 from 1991, he is working in CSE department. Similarly, 403 from 3rd 93, he is going to work in CSE department. But before that, 403, he worked up to 1992 in the ECE department. So you got this many to many relation, right? So guy number 403, he is going to work from 92, he works in ECE department. Then from 93 onwards, he is going to work in a CSE department. Now, let us relate to this person, Chipley. So, I can say 516, the employee ID 516, from this day he is going to work in a AAA department. Similarly, the employee ID 223, he is going to work in this, from 92, he is going to work in a AAA department. So, in this way, we are going to make different inferences using this association, using relationships, and using a relationship set. So these are the three items. After this, the other way of representing a relation will be using ternary relation, using a word called as a ternary relation, T-E-R-N-A-R-Y. So it is going to make the entity set relationship between three entities. It is going to make a relationship between three entities. Now we are going to assume it as ternary relationship. So we have taken up a ternary relationship, and in this ternary relationship we are going to build relations, and that relations we are going to assume not between two entities, we are going to assume it between three entities. The first entity was employee, the second entity was department, and the third entity was location. The first entity will be the employee set, second entity set will be the department set, and third entity will be the location set. The primary key in employee is EMO, because we have underlined it. The primary key in department is department ID, because we have underlined it. Location entity set always shows that a primary key has to be underlined. That is unique and not null. So it has identified location address. It has identified location address as a primary key. And how long the employee was living there? How can I get the relation? I can take an attribute called as since. So since is mentioning how long the employee is what. He is living at that place, we are going to get into this relation. So when we are going to talk about a ternary relationship, it is going to take three entities. First entity is employee, second entity is department, third entity is going to be a location. And if we establish a relationship between three entities, then that relation we are going to call it as a ternary relationship. Next comes a report to relation. Next comes report to relation. So in this we are going to see that we have only one entity set called as employees, and it is going to have attributes called as employee name, employee number, and salary. And it is going to show up supervisor or subordinate relationship. It is going to show up a supervisor or a subordinate relationship. So first one we talked about ternary relationship. So in ternary relationship we have assumed that there will be three entities. Next one, we are going to talk about a self-relationship. So the example for a self-relationship, we are going to assume it as a report to relation. We are going to assume as a report to relation. So in this item, we will be not considering set 1, set 2, set 3. We'll be considering only one set. We'll be considering only set 1, set 2, set 3. There are three sets, but we are going to assume only one set. That too we are going to take it as employee. So employee number, it is going to be a primary key, e-name, again salary. These three items we are going to call them as attributes. Next, what was the relation? The name of the relation was report to. That is, a supervisor reports to himself, a subordinate relates to himself. A supervisor reports to himself and a subordinate reports to himself. I will just give you a graph structure here. First of all, we will be talking about a graph structure here. So assume it is like this. Node A, node B, node C and node D. Okay, we do have A, B, C and D. Now, I'm going to write like this. What is this? We call it as a self loop, right? We are going to call it as a self loop, right? So the distance between A to B is 1, the distance between D to Q is 2, the distance between C to D is 3, the distance between A to B is 1, and again from B to B is 2. Can you write like this? Can you write the graph like this? Yes. So now what is this pipe here? We are going to call it as self-relation. The same concept is going to be given in a report to relation. What is the same concept? Assume we take the CSE department. The head of the department, we are going to call him as supervisor. So subordinates, the faculty in the department, we are going to call it as supervisor. So head of the department reports to himself. Similarly, the subordinates also report to himself. Okay, your HOD teaches you the class. Similarly, his employees also teaches you the class, right? That means both are working in a same department and both are reporting to each other. So the report to relation is that the supervisor belongs to the CSE department, the subordinate also belongs to the CSE department, which we are going to call it as a self loop. So that is regarding that. Next slide. Now, if we are going to make relationship between two entity sets. Relationship between two entity sets, then we are going to call that relation as a binary relation. If the first set is going to be an employee, works in, the second set name was department. Now there are only two sets. Set 1 was employee. Another set, we are entity set, we are going to call it as department. So we are building a relationship between set 1 and set 2. We call it as a works in relation. And if we are going to build in this model, we call that one as a binary relationship. So in binary relationship, we will be having only two entity sets. In ternary relationship, we are going to have three entity sets. If it is a self or if it is a report to relation, then we are going to have it as one. So this is what we are going to call it as unary relation. Self relation is going to be called as unary relation. Binary, there are two items. Unary, one item. ternary, we are going to call it as 3i. So that is the distinction we should understand. So if employee is an entity set, department is an entity set, we need to make a relation, we need to make a association, that is done with a relationship. If the relationship is going to have some attributes, then it is going to be called as a relationship set. So the five terms what we coined today, one, we called it as relation, two, we called it as relationship set, three, we called it as unary, four, we called it as binary, five, we called it as ternary. So these are the five types of relations and relationship items towards the ER diagrams. Next comes mapping cardinality. Next comes mapping cardinality. We actually just now we discussed those mapping cardinalities. So it is primarily focusing on number of entities. It is primarily focusing on number of entities and relationship between different entity sets. It is primarily focusing on relationship between entities and entity sets. Now, there are four ways of mapping cardinalities. There we are going to assume as four ways of mapping cardinalities. One, we are going to call it as 1-to-1. Two, we are going to call it as 1-to-many. Three, we are going to call it as many to one. Fourth one, we are going to call it as many to many. These are the four items that what we are going to emphasize. So mapping cardinalities, they are going to specify entities, they are going to specify entity set, and they are going to specify the relationship between the entity sets. How they are going to represent? They are going to be represented with 1-to-1, 1-to-many, many-to-many, and many-to-one. So the first diagram, A and B, we are going to assume set 1, set 2, set 3, and set 4. Then we are going to assume in this model, and this is what we are going to call it as 1-to-1. We map the items between one entity set and another entity set. We can call it as A1, A2, A3, A4. This is B1, B2, B3, and B4. Next comes one to many relationship. We take two items, A and B. Then we assume there are four items in the set, A1, A2, A3, and A4. Here we are going to assume four items, B1, B2, B3, and B4. Next, we are going to assume Next slide. Assume we are going to assume the third relation, that is many to one. So when we are going to call it as many to one relation, so one it is going to map up to the many of the items. One it is going to map up to the many of an items. And the final one, many to many, we take two sets A and B with A1, A2, A3, A4 as their instances, B1, B2, B3, B4 as B set instances, and we can give this to then we say it is a mapping cardinality between many to next comes the word key constraints. Next comes the word called as key constraints. When we are going to talk up with a key constraint, we will be putting up first one as a primary key. And this primary key, we are going to assume it as some unique and not null. And the second way we are going to take was a foreign key, which we are going to assume it as a referral key, and it should be a primary key in the other table. The basic condition was it must be a primary key in the refer table. So this was the basic condition what we have to understand. So when we are going to deal with the key constraints in entity relationship, we have weak entities, we have the primary key entities, that is we call it as strong entities, etc. When representing these entities, we are going to put in this a primary key and a foreign key scenario. So when we represent a primary key scenario, we assume that key is going to be unique and not null in that entity set. Similarly, when we are going to call it as a foreign key, it is assumed as a referral key, and the compulsory condition for a foreign key, the compulsory condition for a referral key is that it must be a primary key in that table. So from where the table it is coming, that table it should be a primary key. So if we are calling it from another table, in that another table it must be a primary key, then only we can call it to our DAX. So that is regarding the key constraints first criteria. Now looking into the second way, looking into the second way, that is employee. He is going to be given with some employee number, employee name, and salary. Then we are going to put it with working relation, that is with since. Next, we are going to put it with some department. And department, we are going to assume it with some department ID as a primary key. Department name and budget. Now, we have taken two tables. One we call it as an employee, two we call it, one we call it as an employees, another we are going to call it as department. One we call it as an employees, another we are going to call it as department. So, the primary key what we are going to assume in this employee should be unique and normal. So, we are nominating this employee name. So, when we are going to put a key constraint here, we should be getting an underline here. Next one. I want to link table 1, that is an employee set, with department set. I need to link an employee set with a department set. So how can I do it? I can make a relationship set with working or since. Or I can build a relation if there is no since here. That is done. Now, this department ID, if I am going to call it as a primary key, now I can call employee ID is going to be a primary key. Now, what is foreign key here? Foreign key I am going to call it as department ID. So, employee ID is called as a primary key. Department ID is going to be called as foreign. So, what was the compulsory condition? What was the compulsory condition of it is a referral key and it must be a primary key in the reference table. It must be a primary key in the reference table. So, department ID is a primary key. Therefore, we are going to make a reference. We are going to make a reference. Then it is going to have strong, it is going to have strong entity set. It is going to be called as a strong entity set. Next comes participating constraint. Next comes participating constraints. Next comes participating constraints. Now, we are going to change the relation. We are going to change the relation. Works in, we are going to call it as managers. We are going to call it as managers and we are writing an arrow. we are riding a arrow. You have to observe the change. You have to observe the change before the diagram and this present diagram. What was the change? Earlier it was waxing. Now we have made it a manages. Change number one. Change number two. Now we are putting an arrow mark. Now we are going to put an arrow mark. And now what we are going to push? Yeah. Assume the head of the department. Assume the head of the department changes every 2 years. Let us say, assume the head of the department, or we are going to call it as supervisor. He is going to change every 2 years. So now, will the since date change? Yes or no? Yes. Now, will the previous employee and the present employee belong to the same department? Yes or no? Yes. So, that is what we are going to call it as participating constituent. In one case, in one duration, one employee was a supervisor. After that, another person got a chance. So from this to this duration, this person is a supervisor. Later on, another person was a supervisor from this date to this date. But both of them, they are going to work in a same department. Both of them, they are going to work in a same department. We say such one as a participating constraints. So when participating constraints are going to be taken up, we are going to use arrow. Okay? We are going to use arrow. So this is all for today. Thank you.